I've been creating tech companies since 1999, and I have brought technologies to life that I turned into innovations, because technologies alone are pretty useless. So you need to harness them, you need to make them usable to the end user, and then only it becomes an innovation. Whenever I started a company, and those companies have been pretty successful, so today there are probably around 500 million people every day using the innovations that we bought. When you start a company to do such a thing, you're always facing the same problems. We actually want to turn a technology into an innovation, but what we end up doing with is administration. Building teams, getting all the infrastructure ready, do everything but really innovating. So SemiLimes is about helping companies to be innovative, to focus on their core competences instead of doing all that stuff that they really need to do. But it also helps them to find the right people, to build teams that really excel and can bring innovations to the market that really are smashing. So I've mentioned before the lunch break that I would love you to see on the platform. So we created this passphrase. It's up.semilimes.com/p/TUL2017. It's valid for the period of this conference. If you sign up, you can stay on the platform, but if you sign up later in the conference, the passphrase will be closed. So it all starts with sign up, and what you're actually doing is you sign up as an identity. So you, Cedric, you sign up with SemiLimes, and we start verifying your identity by sending you an email. You can reach certain levels of trust by really making sure that you, Cedric, are really you, Cedric. So there will be an SMS validation, there will be other types of validations of your true identity, and we need that because trust is the foundation of business. Trust is behind every company, and it is, by the way, also required by banking laws. This know your client concept is very important. So let me start with my identity. So I created a user profile. I'm Ronald, by the way. So here you can see my user profile. It's a bit like LinkedIn. You can put your CV, your education, your skills that you think you're good in. You can give yourself a tagline, a short description, your work history, the place where you live. Well, I don't live in Liège, but anyway, you can also enter a couple of addresses there. So when you are there, you can decide whether you want to make your profile public or not. So this is the first decision you can make. Do you want to be, first of all, available for hire? So that certainly applies to all the system integrators here in the room. So if you want to present your skills to others, you can just press available for hire here, and you can say how many hours per week you're available and what hourly rate you're going to charge. So if you do that, your profile will appear in the directory in the freelancer section. So if you're searching me here, I can see my own profile, and you can see what I've been doing. And obviously I cannot connect to myself, but I have already, I'm a pretty popular guy, I have already 74 connections, yeah. By the way, you can also see my availability status, because right now I'm on the platform, but I'm not on Messenger. We'll come to that in a minute. But you see that I'm online. I can also search other people, so there's Dennis, for example. I'm already connected to Dennis, so I can invite him to join one of my companies. I can also connect to any type of individual. This one I'm already connected to. So whenever I'm already connected, did anyone sign up recently? can search companies that are registered, that I can register myself or that I can work for. I can search individuals that have been making themselves available for hire. They are listed in the freelancer section, and I can search individuals that I'm just interested in to connect with. So I don't necessarily need to be available for hire to be listed here. And obviously, I can very granularly decide what type of information I want to expose to the portal to other Semivimes users and what I want to keep private. Okay. I can also set primary, secondary emails. So I'm pretty flexible in building my profile. So once I have created my profile, I can create an entity, okay? And that is pretty easy. So an entity can be anything from a non-profit organization to a company. So let's do the Triton Foundation. So this is going to be a non-profit organization. I will make this a US because right now we have implemented the charts of accounts only for US and for Canada. Those are going to be our primary markets to start with. And it's going to be, well, any type of non-profit organization. And Triton is going to do, I don't know. What are we doing? Yeah, what are you doing anyway? Software. So now I have a Triton Foundation here. So this is already a container. This is my container which I can use to work with other people. So this container comes with a set of tools. And the tool is basically a Triton, which we configure through an inspector and a configurator. You will see that in a minute. So you don't need to install Triton and then go into Triton and configure everything there. But you have a very convenient questionnaire that you are going to be guided through depending on the modules that you require to run your business or your foundation. And also comes with a web portal builder that allows you to use your private sales channel on the Semivimes platform. So, I'm going to start configuring an ERP for this Triton Foundation. And I'm going to start from scratch, only to show you how easy it is to do that. So I'm only going to do accounting and tax. I can also click the other modules, web portal, online shop, etc. So what happens now is that we have built a very extensive backend infrastructure, and that shouldn't even be noticeable by users of this platform. But what happens is we are now inspecting the modules that are going to be installed, and we are extracting the questions that we need to ask to properly configure that module. And that happens without Triton even being installed. So it's a dynamic questionnaire that is being composed depending on user input. And you can walk through that questionnaire, go back and forth. You can exit that questionnaire. Somebody else who might be more experienced in accounting than you are can jump in. So let me show you how it works. So we call it Triton Foundation. It's a US company with, let's make it a Washington Foundation, give some sort of a number here. Jonathan know more about the nexus and other numbers, company address. So we select United States, and then automatically we have state, making the Washington Corporation. By the way, if I select, for example, Canada, I will be indicated the provinces that I can select. So it is, there's already some business logic in the configuration. So we try to make it really easy for people who onboard here. Trying to use a real address. Company language, English, obviously, company currency, United States, dollar. So you see, whenever I want to proceed and there's a mandatory field that will be indicated that I still need to fill that out. Company time zone, we are still using the Python approach, which really sucks because I never know. I would like to have something like GMT plus minus, so we are going to change that also because I really don't know where to find the time zone that corresponds to the company. Well, should be probably Los Angeles, at the West Coast. But you get my point. I mean, this is painful, it should be changed. Right? Okay. Next. So now, chart of accounts. Okay, I'm going to set up US chart of accounts. Okay, A4, no, they have letter. And I'm going next, fiscal year. Now, this is something that I'm really not good in. So let me call for help. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to exit this. And by the way, I can also give this what should we do? Should we use this logo here for the transformation? I didn't upload it previously. But now I need people who help me. I need some accountant, you know, so I can invite other team members and I give them admin rights because they need to help me setting up the company. And who would be better suited than Cedric Crier? So I'm sending him an invitation and I'm waiting for his reply and he has no laptop. So I don't know, maybe I can invite another person. So Cedric is... So I'm going to ask Artem. Artem is always reliable. Artem is our business analyst, by the way. He's expecting. So Artem is going to help me, and he's not only going to help me on the admin side, but also on the HR side. And okay, so far I didn't even configure the whole system yet, but I can continue now. So Artem, he now has access to this configuration script, and he can continue the job that I'm doing right now. So I'm pretending to be Artem. I do my fiscal year. It's going to be a half year, starting in July 1st, and it's going to end in 2000, and by the way, you can also do that in a more elegant way, in 2018, by end of June. Okay, we are using Anglo-Saxon counting method, and want to go on, but okay, we need a fiscal period, so you are creating a monthly, and so on and so forth. So I can go through the whole thing, and configure my system, which will completely install my ERP system, and if I have selected the web portal or the web shop, it will also do the web portal. So I hope you get my point. We didn't even configure or we didn't even fire up Triton yet. We do that completely outside Triton. So we inspect the structure of each and every module to be installed. We look at the dependencies, we create buffers because some of the inputs are going to be reused in other modules afterwards. And we made it human readable and maybe a linear process that will guide you through the whole configuration setup. So I could do this now forever. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create a demo. But what we can do is once we have, and this is interesting for you guys as system integrators. So once you have done a configuration for a specific system type, let's say business to consumer web shop in Germany with whatever, you can store that as a template. And what Artem has done, he has created, together with Chris and Nikolai, they have created a North Dakota cutlery manufacturing and rental company. So, and they went through that whole configuration process, including the configuration of the web shop, and they have stored it as a template. And that template, no wonder, it's available for me now, and it's called North Dakota Zero, because it's really initial prototype. So I'm launching now a configurator based on a template that is already pre-populated. And because it's a huge template, we have almost tried to use all features and functions that are available in Triton. It obviously takes a little longer to load. So this is already a pre-populated configuration schema where we have North Dakota Catering Suppliers Corporation, we have the company numbers, we have the DUNS, which is obviously the credit rating company, and we have another number which I'm not familiar with. We have the addresses here that you can enter, and again it's all dynamically configured. So I can use those inputs. Everything is already pre-configured. Wherever I want to change something, for example I'm not happy with the with the A4, I can change that, but the rest will just configure the way I want it. So I can run through that whole configuration schema and set up my company from scratch. And I can modify wherever I want that. So I can really create the business-specific template that I can deploy in. How much did you say that you needed for your web shop? Oh, a month? Okay, that's the talk of tomorrow then. This food company then?
How long?
For we took up 1 month.
Okay. So, yeah, it also takes a little longer to create those templates, but... so now this whole thing is going to be deployed.
What is happening in the background?
What is happening in the background? Alex, you want to show what's happening in the background?
Just some words, what is happening now?
Modules are being installed into Triton.
Okay. Yeah, the modules are currently being installed into Triton. You asked me to repeat everything, so I feel a bit dumb, but anyway, for the audience on the internet. Okay, so modules are going to be installed in Triton. So we are configuring block by block. So we can wait here, as Jan said, 10 minutes can be terribly long, but this is really, I mean, that's why we wrote here. We are doing all the
legwork.
We are doing all the legwork. But the cool thing is, I'm a good entertainer, so I'm going to take you to some other things, and we can just add the demo ERP here, which will run the same thing that we are now configuring in this configuration step, but it was a database dump that I'm reusing now. And so what I'm going to show you now is the whole tool chain that we have developed around Triton. So obviously we wanted the user interface to be also mobile friendly, so we have developed a web client in Scratch. It's written in Angular. We use Material Design to give it a really sleek and mobile-friendly appearance. And we have also developed a bit like Weebly Wix style web portal builder that was done by Nikolai mainly. And so you now have the two elements. You have the ERP web platform and we have the front end, which we also installed because we chose that we wanted to have web portal and also web shop. So let me quickly walk you through the ERP client. So of course everything comes very reduced to the max. And you will see that there's a notifications icon here and there's a messenger icon here. So what is that? I've invited Artem and I have invited Cedric. We don't want to use Google Hangout or Skype for Business. We want to be fully integrated. So I'm going to create a messenger channel here, for example, accounting. And that messenger channel is going to be accessible to all my accountants in the system. So in that case, I didn't configure the ERP system yet, so I cannot yet select a role accounting, but what I can do is I can, for example, give the admin very granular access to that channel. So I could give them read, write access or manage settings or whatever. So now I have created a messenger channel. I have created roles that are assigned to users, and one of the access rights in the admin role is the access right to an institutionalized communication channel. Okay. So if I go to Messenger, I will see all my contacts, and I can contact with anyone in the system by, if he is not already my contact yet. Jan, you signed up before. Do you have your laptop open as you promised?
No.
I can see that. He's lazy because he's not in green. So I'm going to call Konstantin. He's more reliable. I mean, let's call Konstantin. So here's Konstantin. You just need to turn around. So so we built basically something like for business. And I cannot only do a face-to-face call with Konstantin and send him a nice messenger. I can also send him files. Well, he's maybe not happy if I send this file, but it's even with file preview. So even if you send a Word file or PDF files, you get a preview. And you can obviously also download them. So now we have a face-to-face call. By the way, I will make Konstantin also a member. So I will also give him admin access. I know that he's always on Konstantin. I'm sending him an invitation. So you see that, Cedric has, cool, that's actually a system message here. Cedric woke up. Cedric accepted my invitation to join the Triton Foundation. So Cedric now has received a message and he has accepted my invitation. So he's now part of my team and I see that here because he's no longer, he has become an admin. Okay. So he's now working with me on the team. You should be able to open the configurator, jump into it and configure whatever you are with. Anyway. That's the whole idea. And Cedric, he is also an admin, and he has now access to this institutionalized channel that I created. So Cedric is automatically, during the period that he's working for me, or in the Triton Foundation team, he has the possibility to access this institutionalized channel. So that I don't need to invite him to that channel. So I could give to all my accounting members or all my sales team members or all my whatever team members, I could give them access to a particular channel where they can exchange information, files, do video conferencing calls, and they only have access during the time when they actually work on it. So those are the channels. And then, of course, we have the chats. And let me see if Cedric is also... Cedric. Oh. Did you? Oh, I don't see you here. Did you sign up with another user? Udo is there. Nikola is there. Where is Cedric? Cedric, here you are. Okay. So anyway, the idea is now we have something like LinkedIn where you can build a profile. We have ERP system. We have a web portal builder. We have a communication tool. We have a notification channel there behind the scenes where we can broadcast system communications. We can also invite anyone to Semiline. So it doesn't necessarily need to be a team member. So you can invite on Semiline's platform level and you can invite on your team level. So I can just invite a friend to just sniff around and look what's going on. So he doesn't necessarily need to be a member of my team. Okay, so we have the, what's this, server call? That, well, it could be that there is a Wi-Fi that we have reached here. Let's see how it goes on. So I can very granularly assign roles. I can define new roles. I can add a role. For example, I can add a role like accountant. And then I can define the roles on an entity level. What do I want to expose on the ERP side, on the messenger side, on the recruiting and team members? I have the team members that I can manage here, and I can look at the tools themselves.
Unfortunately, I'm the bad guy. I would like to remind you, we have 30 minutes. Now we have 15 minutes left, including the discussion time.
Yeah.
So it's a decision we can follow longer, and there is another talk from Ronald, so we can discuss after the other talk. But we only have 15 minutes, then we must really cut, because...
Why don't you just ask your questions at the dinner? I will just continue my walkthrough and then...
So is it okay for you, we listen more?
Yeah.
Yeah. Good.
And for technical details, that's going to be covered tomorrow. If you want to see or you want to know how we make Python stateless and how this whole inspector configuration schema works, this is going to be covered tomorrow. Okay, so anyway, I told you we have the ERP web client here. Let me quickly walk you through that. So obviously there is a search function here. I can go for parties, for example. Parties. And that's not very good because I should actually...
It's still down. In the end, it's still down.
What?
F1. To Y?
Just parties.
Party.
Connection.
No Wi-Fi.
I think there's a connection problem. Let's see. I can at least access it. No, this is definitely not our problem right now.
It's connection problem. The same on our side.
Hmm?
It's connection problem.
And the problem problem is connection.
Good. Good connection.
Once you travel with the browser and try to go to some page, and then it asks you to do your three problems. Can you use my computer? I have a logo.
Yeah, sure. Let me see what's happening.
I mean, other network.
You have another network?
Yeah,
I can use your computer, no problem. If you can connect it to this beam, Udo, can you give me another 5 minutes? I mean, that's really not my fault.
So now,
Cedric, you have to adapt this.
Thank you. And then, and the resolution is also different. So I'm going to log out and I'm going to log in again. So I mean my account. And here we are back again. So we are back in Triton Foundation. And luckily, thanks, John, you saved my presentation. So I'm going back to the ERP here. Oh, by the way, we also have a little guidance. Cedric mentioned just before that he was a bit confused by the navigation system, so we implemented also this walkthrough guidance that will show you that actually, if you are looking for the menu, it's going to pop up here. So, Cedric, that input really helped us. So, let me show you how the search works. Yeah, it works. Party parties. So you see that it was really more initial. So, of course, I can bookmark this now. I can bookmark it, and I can also look at, for example, currencies. Currencies. I can also bookmark the currencies. I can arrange the bookmarks, however, I don't know how this works. Yeah, I can leave it, for example, if currencies are important to me. What I can also do is I can create filters, and you obviously know about those filters. So I'm now going to sort all, not the rupee, but the rupee. So I'm setting a filter called rupee, and the really cool thing now is that you can set this as a preset, I'm calling it rupees of the world. I'm going to save that preset. And because it's such a sophisticated filter that I need to run every day, I'm going to share that with Cedric, because he also needs it in his daily work. So he can now use the same report that I just gave him.
You are using the inside favorite? No, the client side. No. Oh. No, it is the same table in the Triton database, like Fabric.
That's just a new front end.
Yeah, I know, but you used already.
It's the same.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, obviously there are also some other cool features, like we've implemented Kanban view here, and obviously nothing is shown right now because I first need to select time period where my transactions appear and where doesn't it show up? Maybe it's in the wrong order. Let me see. Here. I don't know why this database is not. Oh, here it comes. So I have all my sales invoices in the different folder in the different stating. What's the plural of status? Stating? I don't know. Statuses. Well, anyway, I can do that. Thank you for your message. I can look at it in this view. Of course, we have also created other views, like for example, projects. Projects. Then we have a Gantt view. So remember, this is a cutlery manufacturer. The cutlery manufacturer also has projects like entering the European market or something like that. So let's have a look at what our projects are for this period here. I'm still the mouse guy, you know. I mean, I'm a technology dinosaur. There's a bump here. Ah, here we go. Here we go. Okay, so you can also connect. You can switch. I'm really having some trouble here with the mouse. Let me see if I can get that. Yeah, you can connect tasks. You can also change deadlines. It's all dynamically updated. All that stuff was done by Alex Vigov, and he's also now working on the pivot table, so there will also be a pivot table available. And pivot table will also be shareable, so once you have selected your particular view that you're interested in, you can also share that with other users. Did I miss anything? Ah, yeah, something cool. Of course, we have behind the scenes, there's also an API service gateway running. We have an asynchronous message bus. And we are consuming also services like, for example, tax calculation. This might be interesting for you, Jonathan. You have like 11,000 different tax points in the US. Because you have state tax, county tax, whatever tax, and it depends on the warehouse location and the destination where the goods go and on the nexus number. So we have implemented a tax chart interface, so the taxes are automatically calculated. And here we have automated exchange rate updates, so we can, for example, add add that to our currency table and we can update it. And then we get the most recent exchange rates. They are available through the API interface. So you can also run that periodically through Chrome jobs. So lots of new features here. Maybe something that is also cool to mention. Let me go back. Going to use the shortcut. So we are still in the rupees. So I'm jumping, I'm in list view now. I'm jumping into form view. And I'm moving forward. So remember, this is all web-based. And I can also move to a subsection here, for example. I can also create a node. So we are now in Pakistan Ruby. I'm going to create a node here. And that's a node to just highly volatile currency update daily. That's a node to my accountants. And the switch text obviously red. And I'm going to save that. And I'm doing data maintenance, so I'm moving from one record to another and I'm always ending up in the nodes. So I can see also for the shell rupee if there's a proper node already in there. And now I'm moving back to this view and so you end up in this view again. Exporting, importing also works with drag and drop. So you can decide what you want to export, what you want to import. Did I miss anything important? Probably not. No. So those are the usability features. Before ending this talk, I would also like to show you the web portal designer. So it's a bit big, sweepy style. When you jump into the page settings, Well, you can also, it's mobile friendly, so you can also look at it in mobile news, how will it look like in a mobile environment. So we have the actual builder where you can build the page, we have the menu page, and we have the templates page, and there you can select the different themes. So we have a couple of themes that web designers can use to start with. Menu, of course, we can add a new menu, and we made that because it's Triton Foundation, we have Triton Foundation page, and there's all sorts of search engine optimization stuff that you can also add to it. You can make it a private page. So I'm going to save that here. So it will pop up here at this place. So Triton Foundation is so incredibly important. I need to have that at the very top here. So we make it the post menu point. And then we think, okay, maybe it's not that important. Let's make it the sub menu of home. And here we go. So this is how you build your menu. Okay. And then when you're in the builder, I'm now in, let's start with the Triton Foundation page. Now I have a little problem, Jan, because I don't want to access your files. I don't know what kind of files you have there.
I need a big old one.
No, it's okay. Let me go to I don't know. The same, by the way, there's a shop functionality, there's a blog, there's a form, it's all powered through the backend. So that's
to store the contents in the in Postgres?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So we want to, okay, I cannot, well, let's suppose we wanted to add a new block here. I'm still the mouse guy, I have to admit, but it's really drag and drop. It's quite easy, so you can resize, you can change the text. This is not Bison, this is Cedric. We have engagement widgets, for example, where you can have newsletter subscriptions. The newsletters will end up in the ERP system, so you can process them through the CRM. And we have, let me add something like Google Maps here. So that's, here in Liège. Because he has a German OS. Yeah, those Germans. So anyway, there are lots of widgets that you can use here. Just add the title or add a spacer or divide or do a gallery or...
Can you have multiple versions of the same page and decide what commissioning version?
Yeah, you can publish and unpublish, and you can...
But a new version, if I make a change, I may want...
You mean a revision history? Or?
Yeah.
No, it's
published within 1 month, because I'm preparing a new big event or something like that, and I just want it.
Sorry, Jan. I'm exposing your whole private life.
Nothing...
There's no hidden charges with Jan. You can work on a, you can copy entire blocks and move them to another page and then run that page in private mode until you decide to publish it. You can even give it a publishing date that also applies to blocks. You want some scheduled publishing? I'm not sure if I get your
question. I don't know.
It's possible. Yeah.
The title here that you just added,
yeah.
Is it already published?
Yes.
Yeah.
I can show you my new one. I have done the same, but you can hide each top.
And so what you would do normally,
that's a good,
when you create
attention.
A new page, you would make it unvisible or unpublished, then you mess around and then you publish it.
I'm thinking about the next step. Your website is online, mm-hmm. and you want to make some changes, mm-hmm. but you may want to change multiple times.
What you want to do is you want to copy a page, leave it unpublished, do your changes, and then publish it. I mean, look, it's. I think this drag and drop, what you see is what you get, is pretty cool. But it comes with the drawback that you don't have the same wealth of managing features that you would have in a traditional content management system. But it's all interlinked, so it's really, it's not a web page builder, but it's a web portal builder. It's really, I mean, the web shop actually, the web shop is powered by the ERP system, including this document. So, you go to the shop, you see stock levels and the product pictures and the product variants, they all come from the ERP system. And the same applies to the forum and the blog. So the blogs are actually created in the ERP, can also be published, unpublished. Categories are managed through the ERP system, forum. So the idea is really to have a seamless integration with where the data should sit with the ERP system. Did I forget anything? Yeah. You can also white label that. So right now it's a semi-line subdomain, obviously. But in settings, you have the possibility to add your custom domain. And because this ERP is not activated yet, you cannot do it. But the moment you activate it, you can run it as a customer. You can also have your own SSL certificates that you can assign to that page. So it's completely white label. Yeah. So we've done a walkthrough of what has been done so far since the last conference in Barcelona. We are going to obviously extend the whole API service gateway so that you can connect to any type of service. But maybe more of that tomorrow. I think Udo is already checking the others. So. I think we.
One question. I know it isn't open source, but the modules you have built, is there a web repository to see them? For example, CRM?
CRM, we actually didn't build any CRM. Well, there are some Triton extensions that we built, but they are pretty much infrastructure dependent.
Oh, okay.
But the idea is really that, I mean, of course it's an illusion. If you use this system, you use a whole ecosystem. And you will not be able to reproduce that on your own. There is a whole infrastructure behind the scenes that is running and is really powerful and also needs proper maintenance.
And if I use it, can I push my own modules in?
Yes, you can do that. Yes. But we will need to approve that because as I previously said, no, we want to make sure that users of this ecosystem are in a safe environment. So there is going to be some quality check because you can do a lot of harm. It's stateless, so there's only one private instance running, but all the users have different databases. But yeah, that's also. If you want to push modules, you're more than happy to include them. And again, the idea is that if somebody uses this Triton as an ERP system, he should not be vendor locked, so he should be able to dump his database. And of course, he needs to work on it to make it work on the standard Triton environment. But it's not like he would go into a complete closed source solution. But on the other hand, this is more about an ecosystem. It's not just the ERP system. It's also the whole communication. We mimic functionality of LinkedIn, where you can build relationships and all that stuff. So reproducing that in your own environment is going to be pretty difficult. So in that sense, of course, things are going along. And yeah, so this is for the time being. I can tell you about seminars. There's going to be more. We're going to introduce also a marketplace with a, what we call universal transaction engine. It's a blockchain secured. I'm not talking about cryptocurrency, I'm only talking about blockchain secured transactions where you can set up smart contracts. And yeah, so there's going to be a lot more stuff. This is now in alpha stage, so you can go on it, you can break it, you can shout at us. There's no guarantee that your data is going to be migrated at this point in time. I think during the course of next year we will be in a state where we can really say, okay, this is going to be better, your data is secure, we are going to guarantee also data migration if there's a version. Okay.